Heart to Home Bible Study. Tonight we are diving into part 7 of Supernatural Provider. You do not want to miss this one. It is so encouraging, but it's also, I believe, very prophetic for what we're going through today in our world and through our systems and through economy and the nation's economy. So I encourage you, grab a pen, grab a piece of paper, grab your Bible, and let's dig into what God has for us.
We need to understand we're not natural people. We've been born of God. Yes. We're a part of the family of God. And that makes us supernatural people.
Hallelujah.
And because of that, God has given us some promises in His Word that He stored us up some things, stored us up bank accounts, stored us up provisions that you and I may need in these days that are ahead. Now, I'm not telling you pack up your bags, it's time to fly away. I'm trying to tell you is that this is the time God has promised He will give us wealth transfers.
Yes.
He will provide for every need that we have individually or in our churches or in our communities. So we're going to look first at Proverbs, almost at Psalms. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 22. I love this scripture.
Amen. So in the book of Proverbs, chapter 13 and verse 22, it says, "A good person leaves an inheritance for their children's children."
No, that would be grace.
You have to do it for grace. Come on now. Put me in that will.
Ah,
but a sinner's wealth is stored up for the righteous. And that's what we're focusing in on today, is a sinner's wealth is stored up for the righteous.
And if I remember, King James said that the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just.
Mm.
And the just shall live by faith. And we have to hold on to that. God has provided for each one of us the abilities to do and to pay and to see the kingdom of God come even more fully on this earth.
Yes.
And it happens because the wealth of the sinner, you know, I think we all have said that, the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just.
Yes.
And also in providing for our family. You know, I know you had said that there's one guy who teaches on finances. And he said, you don't have to provide for your kids, or don't feel guilty if you don't.
Yeah.
I would feel terribly guilty. I want to make certain that I have something for them. But you know what? Who really wants to make certain that we're taken care of? That's God Himself.
Amen. God loves blessing us abundantly, and He loves pouring out His blessing. And this wealth transfer that we're talking about, we see it in the scripture, especially in the book of Exodus, where we saw that transfer take place with the people of Egypt, the Egyptians, to the Israelites, to the Hebrew people. And that transfer took place. And that's just one example of that transfer taking place.
And we've seen it in other places as well, where God provides for those who need food.
Yes.
I mean, we saw that last week in the Old Testament and the New Testament. So let's look at Psalms 105, verse 37, another scripture that shows us His provisions.
Amen. So this is speaking of actually the people of Israel being brought out of captivity.
Amen.
And into the promised land. It said in verse 37, God brought out Israel laden, that means overwhelmed, carrying, their buggies were full with silver and gold, and from among their tribes no one faltered or was feeble. Another word for that would be sick or disabled.
That's right.
or dealing with a physical need. And so we see that God doesn't just lavish things. He's so good. He lavishes food and prosperity and abundance in finances, but prosperity is all-encompassing.
Right.
Right? So here we're seeing that He not only poured out financial materials, silver and gold, but He also poured out healing, because for some of us, you can have trillions of dollars in the bank, and yet if you don't have your health, if you don't have the health of your family, health and relationships,
right,
what good is that money?
But I want to tell you, the time is now.
The time is now. Glory
to God.
Now.
It's not because the political scenario says it is. I'm telling you, that's what the Word of God says. He's letting us know on earth as it is in heaven. You know, I think I was looking back at one of the Bible studies we taught, and we talked about one of the roads right outside,
yes,
that it was actually paved just recently. So glad. Potholes were horrible.
They were bad.
And it's kind of nice to go down this road now. It's so smooth. And as I was listening to that Bible study, yes, I watched the Bible studies, I was reminded about the streets in heaven. Mm-hmm. And God desires to give us silver and gold. God desires to give us the provision for the needs that we're looking at. And the time is now. Say the time is now.
The time is now.
That's what Jesus wants us to get a hold of. He wants us to know that He is our provider, Jehovah Jireh. And He will provide for us. So let's look at this. James chapter 5, verses 1 through 4. And when Michelle read it, she said, boy, this is really, really kind of tough. And it's like it is, because God is warning all of us, don't cheat. Yeah. Don't try to make it your own thing. Let me work my power, my anointing for you.
Amen. What's so interesting with the scripture also, that when we were reading it, is it's very relevant for today. The entire word of God is relevant for today.
You would think that.
But this is extremely relevant to the point you feel like you're reading a news clip. That's how relevant it comes across. So James chapter 5 and verse 1, it says, now listen, you rich people, weep and wail because of the misery that is coming on you. Your wealth has rotted and moths have eaten your clothes. Your gold and your silver are corroded. Oh, there's no lasting promises and goodness with the things of this world. The things of this world are going to corrode. They're going to fade. The fame will fade. The accolades will fade. What stands eternal? The word. Jesus even said, heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will remain forever.
That's right.
So it's His word that lasts, not things. It's Him. Yes. It is Jesus. He is the foundation of eternity. It goes on and it says that their corrosion will testify against you and eat your flesh like fire. You have hoarded wealth in the last days. Verse 4, look, the wages you failed to pay the workers who mowed your fields are crying out against you. That blood is crying out. The cries of the harvesters have reached the ear of the Lord God Almighty. I'm just reading all this, aren't I?
That's okay.
The whole point of this scripture is that the rich, and when we think rich, we say, well, then I need to give all my money away.
No.
The rich is those people who have enriched themselves in the things of this world.
That's why the Bible says the love of money.
Yes.
It's not money. It's the love of money.
Where you are exalting money above His word and Him, His presence,
and the people of God. Yeah.
Where, I don't know if you've ever met someone where they are willing to do whatever it takes to get and to make more.
That's sad.
They're willing to cut anyone, lie any lie, and these are sometimes Christians.
Right. Yeah, that's true.
And they are willing to do whatever it takes to be at the top, to make the most, to have the most. And that is the opposite of what God wants us to do and the way He wants us to live. So He's talking about that transfer taking place.
Right, and He's also talking about that the wicked will be drained. Those that have the love of money, that system, the Babylonian system, that is all broken, and the kingdom of God will be enriched. But it's not so that I can have the big fine house and the big fine cars. It's to enrich the kingdom of God, to be able to do what God does. I love when people come to me and they say, how do you do it? You never ask for money. I get that a lot.
And our response is, we have a very rich daddy in heaven.
Yes, we do.
He's wealthy. He's wealthy in wisdom. You know, the right decision will keep you from spending the wrong amount of money.
That's right.
Sometimes God will say, go, and sometimes He'll say, stop. And if you're obedient to His go or His stop, He can get you or keep in your possession a massive amount of money. So there's wisdom in God.
Right.
There's wisdom in Him. There's healing in Him.
Yes, there is.
There's so much peace found in Him. And so we have to look to our Abba Father and go, He provides all that.
That's right, and we tell people that. I don't ask you because you're not my source.
God is my source.
Jesus is my source.
Yes.
I give and it's given back to me. And so often people think that I have to ask you. But see, that's manipulation. I refuse to do that. My job is to love you, to honor you, and as Jesus did, wash your feet. I need to make certain I'm a servant.
Amen.
And when you're a servant, you're going to see that wealth transfer.
Yes.
You're going to see God providing for you in ways that you never thought possible. That you think about something that you truly desire, and all of a sudden someone says, you know, I don't need this. Would you like this? And you're sitting there going, I've been believing God for this.
Yes.
And so I'm telling you, today's the day.
Yeah.
Today is the day for you to understand that on earth, as it is in heaven, God is sending you what is needed. So don't get frustrated. Don't think you're not going to have enough. He'll break that bread and he'll feed your family and your neighborhood. He'll take care of you and your family.
Yes.
Because that's what he loves to do.
Amen. He loves to pour out. So over this nation and over the nations of this world, we just thank you, Father, that,
yes,
that the people who have taken that stand of greed, and I just keep hearing this phrase, dog eat dog, they're willing to do whatever it takes to be in control, to have power.
That's right.
We just pray that that is broken, and that your anointing, your people are arising in this day. And so we are encouraged with what God is doing.
That's right.
Get into the Word. See how this is not just in one portion of the Bible. It's throughout the Word and the Scripture of the Lord. Time and time again where the nations of wicked provided for God's people. And so that's what God wants to do for you.
So why don't you speak that out every day? I made it kind of simple for you because I wanted to be able to do that as well. Provision is coming to me from a higher place, in a higher way, from God's riches and glory.
Glory to God.
And this is something you can declare over yourself and over your family. That is an inheritance you can give to your kids. Every time Gracie stops me, if I don't pray over my food, she stops me and, Grandma, we have to pray. And
she's,
do you know,
awesome,
what an inheritance that is for me?
Yes.
I'm getting all emotional. Absolutely. Pour this into your kids, into your grandkids.
Yes.
Get this. Contact us. And then also, 20 ways God supplies. I have been looking at this over and over and saying, okay, God, what else do I need to do?
Mm-hmm.
What else do I need to give? What else do I need to learn? Because the days ahead are going to be full of His ways that He'll provide for us.
Amen.
So contact us, get these sheets, and start doing what it says to do.
Amen. So we encourage you, dive into the Word, dive into His goodness, and also tune in next week as we learn more about God, our supernatural provider. We love y'all.